சுந்தை குட்டி அண்ணா. மார்னிங், குட் மார்னிங்,
குட் மார்னிங,
குட் மார்னிங் மேம்,
குட் மார்னிங் மேம்,
குட் மார்னிங் மேம்,
குட் மார்னிங் மேம்.
குட் மார்னிங் மேம்,
குட் மார்னிங்,
குட் மார்னிங் மேம்.
Okay, shall we start the class?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, once again, good morning to all.
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning, ma'am.
Had your breakfast? Had your breakfast, all of you?
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
No,
ma'am.
No, okay, okay, fine. Okay, children. So last class, what all things we have discussed?
Layers
of the earth.
Crust.
Ma'am.
Yes.
Crust, mantle, and core.
Crust, mantle, and
core.
Core. Mute your audio, all of you.
Ma'am.
Yes.
Today
Amna's birthday,
only ma'am.
Amna's birthday.
Yes, ma'am. Today Amna's birthday.
Amna, happy birthday to you, dear.
Thank you, ma'am.
Okay.
Happy birthday.
Okay, children. Do you all want to wish her?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, yes. Hi, Anthony. Anthony is smiling. He's looking very pleasant. Okay, so children, last class we discussed about the layers of earth. Okay, the interior structure of earth. Which are the three layers of earth, Anthony? Tell me.
The core.
Now, start from the beginning.
Crust.
Yes, crust.
Mantle.
Core. Okay, core. Crust, mantle, and core. Okay. Angelia, can you tell me about crust? Angelia.
Yes, ma'am.
Tell me, crust.
Crust is the uppermost layer of the earth's surface.
Yes, yes. It is the top layer, the uppermost layer of the earth. Then?
It is the thinnest layer of all.
Thinnest layer of all.
Its
thickness, yes.
35 meter on
35
the
kilometer, not meter. 35 kilometer.
On the continent mass.
Yes. And only? 5
kilometer on the ocean floor.
Okay, good. Prajita, tell me the mineral constituents of continental mass.
Ma'am, the silica and...
silica and...
silica and alumina.
Together it is Cl. Okay.
Then,
yeah. That is? Sima is about...
silica
and magnesium. That means it is in the oceanic
crust.
Okay, oceanic crust. It is silica and magnesium. Together it is Zima. Okay, clear, children?
Yes, ma'am.
Just beneath the crust, it is
Mantle.
Okay, and it's extended to
2900
kilometers. Just the crust, we can see mantle. Okay, and have you heard about magmas, molten magmas?
Yes, ma'am.
How was lava, volcano eruption, and all? Have you studied it before?
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
Oh, okay. No. That we will study in this chapter. Okay. So, crust, just beneath the crust, it is
mantle.
It's still extended till 2900 kilometers. Albert Jojo, which is the innermost layer?
Yes, ma'am.
Which is the innermost layer of the earth?
Core.
Core. Okay, and its radius is about
3500 kilometers,
and its mineral constituents that
nickel
we discussed.
And iron.
Yes, ma'am. Nickel and iron.
Okay, that is nickel and iron. But we will together we will call it as
nickel and ferrous.
Yes, the scientific terms, that means iron. It is ferrous. Okay. Have you noted down on that day? Have you noted?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Knife means nickel. Ni for nickel and for iron, it is ferrous. Okay. Nickel and iron. And here in this outer core, okay, outer core has very high temperature and
inner core. Yes, sir. Inner core.
Yes, yes, the central core. Okay, the central core has high temperature and pressure so that we can't reach to the center of the earth. Okay, if we need to reach the center of the earth, we need to dig a hole till 6000, means its volume. We have discussed the radius of the earth is about
6371 kilometers.
Okay, so more than 6000 kilometers we need to cover, or we need to go to reach the center of the earth. But it is too difficult because we could face high temperature and pressure. Okay, and the volume, the crust forms only 1% of the volume of the earth. Okay, and 84% consists of
mantle,
and 15% makes the
core.
This is about the volume. Do you know the difference between volume and radius?
Yes.
Radius. You have studied in maths, right?
Yes.
Radius.
Yes.
From
yes,
the center to the
and to 1 point.
Yes. Okay, and volume means the total. Means that occupies
space.
Yeah, occupied by the space. Yeah. So these points are clear, children.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, yes, ma'am.
Any doubt? Any doubt?
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am. No, ma'am. Okay.
So next we are going to discuss about. Let me start the class. After that, I will give you the time to write down the points. Okay, so next we are going to study about rocks. Okay, we study that the crust, okay, or the lithosphere, it is made up of rocks and minerals, right?
So
next we are going to study what is a rock, okay, and which are the types of rocks. Okay, so a rock, naturally we can see in and around us, right? Okay, it can be of different size, different color, different texture. Okay, so the real definition of a rock is any natural mass of mineral matter. Okay, natural mass. What do you mean by natural mass? Mass, have you studied in, I think, yes, what do you mean by mass?
A large area.
Weight. So, any natural mass of mineral matter that makes up the earth crust. We can see some things, that means natural mass of mineral matter. It is just a piece of matter that makes up the earth crust, that is called a rock. It is a natural mass of mineral matter. Any natural mass of mineral matter that makes up the earth crust. We have discussed that the earth crust is made up of rocks and minerals. Okay, so what is a rock?
A rock makes up the earth crust is called rock.
That makes up the earth crust. That is called a rock. It can be of different color, different texture, different size. Okay, and mainly there are three major types of rocks. Yes, igneous rocks. It also
called as ma'am, three types of rocks. First
one you have wrote
igneous rocks.
Igneous. Yes. Okay, sorry for the spelling mistake.
Igneous rocks, right? Rocks.
Yes. Igneous rocks.
Sedimentary rocks.
Yes. Igneous rocks. It is also known as primary rocks. It's also known as primary rocks. Sedimentary rocks.
Metamorphic
rocks. Okay, so any natural mass of mineral matter that makes up the earth crust, it is called a rock. A rock can be of different size, different color, different texture. We know that, right? Okay, but here there are three main types of rocks. Okay, that is igneous rocks, sedimentary rocks, and metamorphic rocks. And igneous rocks, it is also known as primary rocks. This igneous, it is a Latin word and it means fire. Igneous, it's a Latin word and it means fire. Meaning fire.
Fire.
Have you heard this term sedimentary before?
Yes, ma'am.
It's a change of forms. Detail after this. So these are the three types of rocks. That is igneous, sedimentary, metamorphic. Ayan, tell me the three types of rocks. Which are the three types of rocks, Ayan?
Igneous. Sedimentary.
Metamorphic. Okay. Igneous, sedimentary rocks, and metamorphic rocks. Three major types of rocks. So we are going to study about igneous rocks first. Okay. See, children, just below the crust and the upper part of the mantle, the place means the place between the crust and the upper part of mantle, there is some molten magmas are there. Okay, molten magma. Or do you hear about lavas? Lava?
Yes, ma'am.
Ah, yes. When the, because yes, of the high temperature and pressure of this layer, okay, the rocks, they began to melt. The rocks, the molten rocks of that part is began to
melt.
Okay, and they will went out. Ah, yes, they will went out to the earth's surface. And that we were called it as volcano eruption. Have you heard about volcano eruption?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, means due to the high pressure and heat, high temperature and heat. Yeah, inside the earth it is too heat, right? We have talked about core and mantle. Okay, the area in means the crust. Crust is the area where the people live in. Children, listen out here.
Sorry, ma'am.
Who is talking?
Ma'am, from where is this lava?
Who is talking?
Gauri.
Gauri, tell me.
She's asking a doubt.
Ask me.
Ma'am, from which layer of the earth is this molten magma coming out?
Which?
Layer of the earth is the molten lava
mantle,
coming
mantle. Okay, that's what I am going to discuss. That is just below the crust and the upper part of mantle. Okay, there this magmas are existing. Okay, and due to the high pressure and heat, or the high temperature and the heat, this magmas began to melt. Okay, Adityan, where are you going in between? Okay, due to the extreme pressure, okay, extreme temperature, this lavas began to melt. Then mute your audio. I can hear some of the sounds from you. Who is not muted? Anan, Hessa, mute your audio. Ms. Yath, turn on your video. Ms. Yath. Ms. Yath, are you there? I think this is not the first time I have seen that Ms. Yath is always, he turn off his video and was sitting. Ms. Yath, can you hear me?
Yes, ma'am.
Turn on your video and sit. Why you are turn off your video and sitting? What's your problem?
Sometimes it automatically off.
I don't think so. Automatically, yes, how it will happen?
And this phone, some problem is.
Okay, children. So what I told you is lava. Okay, it is actually, okay, the fiery. Fiery means hot. Okay, hot, red, molten magmas. Okay, lava, it is a fiery, red, molten magma coming out from the inside, means interiors of the earth. Okay, sometimes this molten magma becomes solid, become cool, and it becomes solid. Okay, sometimes this molten magma, okay, when it comes on the earth surface, it becomes cool and it becomes solid. So this is the way some rocks are formed. Okay, and such types of rocks are known as igneous rocks. Do you understand?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
The molten magma, when it comes on the earth's surface, it becomes solid. It becomes cool and it becomes solid. Okay. And rocks are formed in such a way. Means rocks formed in such a way is known as igneous rocks. I have told you the meaning of igneous is fire. Okay. So this, due to the high temperature and pressure inside, in the interiors of the earth, okay, this red molten magma is coming out, okay, on the earth surface, and it become cool. After then, it become cool and it becomes solid, okay. And rocks are formed in such a way that types of rocks were known as igneous rocks. Okay, do you understand?
Yes, ma'am.
Let me share the screen.
Sorry, ma'am.
Yes.
How it will become cool?
See, in the interior structure of the earth, due to the extreme pressure and temperature, it began to melt. Okay, when it reached into the exterior portion of the earth, that means on the crust, the temperature is not hot like the mantle or core. Do you understand?
They
become cool and it become solid. Okay, so such types of rocks are known as igneous rocks.
Okay, ma'am.
I will write the definition over here. You just write it down. When the molten magma cools, it becomes solid. Rocks thus formed are called igneous rocks. It is there in the textbook. When the molten magma cools, it becomes solid. Okay. Rocks thus formed are called igneous rocks. What is a rock? What is a rock?
Any natural mass of mineral matter
that meets
the earth crust
is called rock.
This we call as rocks. There are three types of rock, that is
igneous rocks,
igneous means fire. Okay, so igneous rocks means that due to the extreme heat and pressure, okay, the lava is coming out, the molten magma is coming out on the earth surface, okay, and it becomes cool and it becomes solid. Okay, and this is the way some rocks have been formed. Such types of rocks are known as igneous rocks. They come the fire. Okay, actually there were molten magmas, right? Molten magmas. So this means it is a combination. Molten magma means, you know, it is a combination of nickel and iron. Okay, so that means it's a broken rocks. Do you understand?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so this lava is coming out. Okay, and volcano eruptions are happening. And when it comes on the earth surface, there will not be such a hard temperature like the interiors of the earth. Okay, so naturally it began cool. It began to cool and it become solid. And rocks are formed in such a way are known as
igneous rocks.
And it is also known as primary rocks.
Primary rocks.
Next class, I will explain more about this one. Okay, about igneous rocks and molten magma. I know that's not clear to you. Next class, I will explain to you and I will clear your doubt. Okay, children?
Okay, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you.